It's frankly baffling how many problems the Boeing 777X has encountered despite sharing its heritage with the legacy 777, a platform known for being one of the safest and most reliable in aviation history. Yet, the 777X has faced setback after setback. Now in 2025, the aircraft is already 6 years behind schedule, and Boeing still uncovers new problems that will almost certainly push the timeline further back, at least to 2026. But even though the 777X is stuck in limbo, it seems like there's still the perfect opportunity to make a strategic move by offering a stretched version of it, the Boeing 777-10X. The issues with the Boeing 777X began long before the aircraft took its first commercial flight. Back in 2019, during an overpressure test, the fuselage unexpectedly tore open at pressure levels far exceeding what the aircraft would encounter in service. Although this failure wasn't deemed a safety threat, since such pressures would never be reached during normal operation, it was an ominous sign of potential underlying design issues. Once the 777X finally took to the skies, problems persisted. One particularly concerning incident involved an uncommanded pitch event where a test aircraft suddenly pitched upward or downward without any input from the pilot. Although the exact cause of the upset remains undisclosed, the incident bears unsettling similarities to the MCAS issues that plagued the 737 MAX. Adding to these woes, engine troubles surfaced in 2022 when a temperature spike forced Boeing to halt testing for several weeks. These early hiccups point to a lack of design maturity. In fact, sources have suggested that the 777X has experienced a host of teething problems during its extensive flight test campaign, which has accumulated over 3,000 flight hours, more than any other program in history. Simply put, it has taken Boeing an exceptionally long time to refine this new design. Recently, Boeing resumed testing for its long-delayed 777X widebody jet in early January, with the first flight since the plane maker grounded the test fleet in August due to the failure of a key engine mounting structure. Due to all of this, the airline customers are growing frustrated. Influential carriers like Qatar Airways and Emirates have built their future fleet plans around the 777X. Despite their deep frustrations with the delays, both airlines have continued to place repeat orders, based on the assumption that the aircraft's issues would eventually be resolved. This is caused by the fact that both airlines desperately want new aircraft of this size, especially Emirates, which currently has 116 A380s in its fleet and will definitely want to replace it over the years. There's, however, one problem. Currently, no aircraft is suitable to fit this role, as the 777-9X is simply too small. According to Boeing, the planned capacity of this aircraft will be around 426 seats in configuration, with small business class and no premium economy, something that Emirates certainly won't agree with, as some of the airline's current A380s already have 615 seats. This is where Boeing might seize the opportunity and finally offer something that will have no competition. Particularly since the past few years, the company seems to be lagging behind Airbus, with, for example, no answer to the A321 XLR that's getting extremely popular, and problems with the 737 MAX. Creating 777-10X, which would be the replacement for A380, would have definitely placed Boeing in a better position on the market. Even now, the 777X has no direct competitor in the market, at least not one that offers the same capacity. Airbus's closest rival is the A350-1000, which seats approximately 50 to 75 fewer passengers. Although Airbus has been steadfast in its belief that the A350-1000 is sufficiently large, recent trends, such as airlines delaying the retirement of their older, gas-guzzling A380s, suggest that there is still significant demand for high-capacity, long-range jets. Around 250 A380s have been built, and most of them would need to be replaced around the end of the decade, which is also perfect timing, as Boeing would definitely need some time to design and test the stretched version, although it should be much easier to do this than to create a completely new aircraft. What would such a plane look like? The beauty of the 777X platform is that a stretch wouldn't require an entirely new design. Essentially, Boeing would only need to add about 4 meters in fuselage length to the existing 777-9 design, thereby adding roughly 40 extra economy seats. This modification could be achieved without redesigning major components like the wing or landing gear, or even adding another exit door. Another benefit of such aircraft would be the possibility of fitting in the current 777 gates without the need for a completely new infrastructure, at least in terms of width, mainly thanks to the foldable wingtips. Unlike the A380, the Boeing 777 series does not also require special gates at airports, and thus is far more flexible for airlines. The length would be a bigger problem, but I will discuss this in a while. Another key factor in this discussion is the engine. The 777X is powered by the General Electric GE9X, a high-bypass turbofan developed by GE Aerospace exclusively for the type. This is the largest and most powerful aircraft engine available on the market. In testing, it has achieved thrust levels up to about 34,000 pounds, well above its typical derated takeoff rating, which stands around 11,000 pounds. And while the engine would definitely need to be at least slightly modified to power the larger 777-10X variant, it still offers a little spare thrust. Despite this, there are still some potential issues that would need to be addressed before designing the 777-10X. The first one is range. Due to the fact that this aircraft would be larger, would likely harbor less range than the 777-9 to make way for the capacity increase offered. According to Boeing's specifications, the 777-9 can fly 7,600 nautical miles or 4,075 kilometers. Meanwhile, the 777-8 can up to 8,745 nautical miles or 6,190 kilometers. So it can be assumed that 777-10 would have a range of around 12,000 kilometers or 6,500 nautical miles. The smaller range would definitely make the aircraft less appealing, however, for most of the routes, this still wouldn't be a huge problem. Another problem that 777-10X would definitely face is length. The 777-9 is already the longest passenger aircraft in the world, surpassing the 747-8 by 0.7 meters. The 10 version would be definitely longer than 80 meters, and there are international that constrain how long an aircraft can be without requiring significant modifications to airport layouts, like the 80-meter apron limit box. A 777-10X stretching the envelope could face compatibility issues at airports not equipped to handle such dimensions. An apron wouldn't be the only problem, as the additional length, though seemingly modest, can be the equivalent of an entire ground vehicle route needing relocation. It's also worth remembering that extending the fuselage may necessitate additional structural reinforcements to maintain integrity and control. This would not only increase the overall weight, but can also affect the aircraft's center of gravity, potentially reducing fuel efficiency and overall performance, making it less efficient, especially taking into account cost per seat. So what do you think about this idea? Should Boeing take the plunge and stretch the 777X further? Or is it a waste of time given the current market dynamics? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you made it this far, I hope you'll consider liking and subscribing. Those simple actions are what keep the channel growing. Until next time.